Well, joining us now, a woman who has previously held the title of Britain's oldest mother, Sue Tollefson, who gave birth to her daughter at the age of 57, and alongside her, Dr. Hillary, to talk about the kind of medical implications of this. But lovely to meet you this morning.
Thank you. Good morning.
57 is obviously quite a significant age to have a baby. Did you find, whenever we talk about this, there is a huge response and an enormous amount of criticism. Did you find that you personally got that?
Yes, I did. When I didn't discover I was pregnant until I was 29 weeks and 4 days, and it came as a shock, but or as a surprise, and a nice surprise.
But you say it came as a surprise, but you were planning this baby.
I was planning it. I'd had IVF treatment. I was confirmed as being pregnant, and then I was told I'd lost the baby, and I had no more treatment. And 7.5 months later, I went to the doctors, and then on to the hospital for a scan at the Nuffield, and they discovered I was 29 weeks and 4 days pregnant. And
you were still hoping to get pregnant at that age.
Yes, I was. Yes.
It wasn't an accident.
Yeah. No, it wasn't an accident. No.
And interestingly, in terms of reading what you've said about the pregnancy, the criticism that you've faced undoubtedly, because we've seen a lot of it this morning, you've said in hindsight your daughter is the best thing that's ever happened to you.
Oh, yes.
But you wish you hadn't left it so late, that too old to have a child.
I think it was taken slightly out of context, and they said, I said I was too old. What I said was I wish I had done it earlier, because, you know, when I finally found out I was pregnant and held her, I thought how fantastic it was. But then, you know, now, as the years have gone on, I have less years in front of me than I have behind me, and I know that, you know, I'm facing my own mortality, if you really want to sort of put it very bluntly. And it saddens me because it's been such a momentous journey and I've had such fantastic joy from her. I wish that I could be there even longer. That, you know, I'm hoping if I could live till I'm 80, which is another 14 years, she'll be 24, 25. But I would love to be there when she's finished university, if she goes, if she gets married, if she has children. And I know that certain things aren't going to be a possibility for me.
One of the things that's thrown at older parents, or older mothers particularly, is that it's selfish. Yeah. Sue has sent an email saying, having a child at 64 is so selfish. The child's going to end up being the parent's carer. They'll not have relationships with mother and child. They'll spend their childhood worrying about parents and their mortality. Mm. They'll spend their teenage years being the parent's carer, filled with guilt. I know I'm a child of older parents. And that is something that comes up time and time again, that having the child so late is a very selfish thing to do because of those reasons.
I had that put to me as well, but I mean, in my case, I actually looked after my mother for 17 years after my father died. I promised him I would, and I did, and she died when I was 51. And I actually thought I'd missed the boat, and I just didn't think that was a possibility. It was just that my then partner came home with some articles from a magazine, and then I actually tried, I sent out various emails, and then I went to Russia, and I was tested psychologically and whether I could carry a child. And we sat and we sort of wrote the pros and the cons, what would we do if anything happened to me, and we thought it out very, very thoroughly. I mean, it's not something you just walk into an IVF clinic and write a cheque and say, right, I'd like a designer baby tomorrow. You do have to jump through hoops.
And Dr. Hillary, it's not something that you can access here, is it, at that age?
No. I mean, the Human Fertilisation and Embryology Authority say to clinics, you know, you mustn't offer this treatment without considering the welfare of the child. So treatments weren't possible for Susan in this country, were
What's
they?
What's the threshold age in the UK?
There's no threshold age. It's based on consideration of individual circumstances, which will surprise many people. So Susan had to pay privately and go abroad, which she did. But she's raised a lot of the points that most people would consider. First of all, her own mortality. She's an older mum and she's only got a certain amount of years ahead of her that the child will have to potentially grow up without a mother at a relatively young age. But also another area is the risks involved, the cost to the society and the NHS if a child, because it has increased risks of congenital abnormalities and preterm birth, there are implications for the rest of society. And for mum too, her health can be affected by pregnancy and the sheer exhaustion of being an older mum. But everyone's individual, everyone's different.
And
Susan's
there's all sorts
a very
of
good mum. She's very good for her age at 66 now. So who's to judge, really? Yeah. But in the UK, you would have to do this privately, and not many clinics would offer it, if any, at all, over 50.
There are all sorts of circumstances which affect us as parents. Yeah. You know, none of us know what is coming.
Sure.
You know, there might be children who lose their parents who are looked after by their grandparents, who are, you know, in a similar situation with their obligations.
Absolutely.
And you know, what happens to them. I mean, you know, it's an extraordinary thing to do. It's obviously very divisive from the comments that we've received, but we appreciate you coming in to talk to us.
The chance of success of IVF anyway is about 2% over the age of 44.
Oliver says on Facebook, if you're happy and healthy and can give a child a loving, stable life, then that's all you need. That's it. Leave people alone.